Hey everybody, Kat here. Thanks for coming back. I have a WW-friendly cookie collab to share with you. I have two entries into the collab, and I want to thank my wonderful hosts, Miranda and also Brittany. I'm going to put both of their channel links below, and I'm also going to type them across the screen. Please go and check them out. And I want to thank these wonderful ladies for inviting me to the collab. This definitely was fun to start looking for some cookie recipes and, you know, get some ideas, especially now during the holidays, right? So I zeroed in on two recipes that I thought were real simple, but also low in points. I'm on the purple plan. When I put them in the purple plan, the first cookie that I have is a peppermint meringue, and that one is coming up as, I think it's 1 point for like two, but I can eat up to six for like 3 points or something like that. And that was like amazing, absolutely amazing. I don't think I would want to eat up to six. I'd probably just eat two at the most. But nevertheless, they're super, super easy to make. Now, when you cool meringues, just a tip, if you don't want them to crack, you need to just leave them, turn the oven off and leave them in there until they're cooled completely, usually about an hour and a half or so. And I left mine about 2 hours and took them out, and none of them were cracked. They were completely smooth. So just a tip. They were absolutely amazing and really cool. And you can add the great thing about these meringues is that you can add any kind of flavor you want. You can, instead of peppermint, use vanilla or orange or whatever it is. You can make a caramel macchiato meringue and add, instead of the peppermint, the half a teaspoon of peppermint, just add a half a teaspoon of caramel extract and maybe a few teaspoons of like a cappuccino powder or coffee powder, right? So anyway, it's up to you. You can go crazy with meringues, but I decided a peppermint one would be nice. And the second recipe is kind of like a whole grain recipe. It's like an orange and cranberry cookie. And I thought it was gonna be overly plain, but to tell you the truth, they're super tasty. And I wanna say mildly sweet, but kind of addicting. And all of my kids really love them. And so I feel good just giving, you know, letting them have two, because really they're whole grain and there's no fat in them. And I think two of them, I think you can have two of them for, what was it? Each one is 2 points. So two of them is gonna be like 4 points. So anyway, I hope you enjoy the recipes and I'll see you next time. Start out by preheating your oven to 225. Let's look at the ingredients that I have. I have a half of a cup of granulated sugar that I just processed into super fine sugar. I also have cream of tartar. It's a quarter of a teaspoon of cream of tartar and just a pinch of salt, and also a half of a teaspoon of peppermint extract. I'm going to be using this kind of sprinkles on top. It's kind of like a flaky, snowflakey look. I want a snowball look. But Michael's also had these little glittery things on sale for $1 a piece. You might want to check out some of their sprinkles. And then also some of these candy cane crunch pieces. I don't know if I'll use these or not. Now I also have two room temperature eggs. I'm gonna separate the whites out of them and put them in my mixing bowl. And I'm going to beat that with the cream of tartar and the salt. And I'm gonna beat it until it's frothy. And then after that is when I'm gonna start adding the sugar in little by little. So now we see we got the froth coming up here, and little by little, I'll be adding about a tablespoon of the sugar, and I'm gonna beat it until thick peaks form, and then that's when I'll stop. Okay, so you can see it's getting kind of thick. I'm gonna add in my peppermint extract. And that's all done. I'm gonna be using this pastry bag here, and I'm gonna be using the thickest little tip on this to pipe out the meringues. So I'm just gonna spoon it in there and use a little Silpat sheet on a cookie sheet, and I'm just gonna make little meringues. It should make about 24. And I'm gonna stick it in the oven, the 225 oven, and I'm gonna cook it for 45 minutes. And then when that's done, I'll just turn it off and let them cool. And look at this with the sprinkles on. Aren't they beautiful? They were so good too, and so refreshing, and just nice and crispy and perfect. I just love them. And they're 1 point for two, or I think you can have up to six for 3 points, so great. Okay, everybody, we are getting this recipe from Secrets of Fat-Free Cooking. Let's see, so let's start off. This is orange oatmeal cookies. These are really, really good. We're gonna start out with 1 cup plus 2 tablespoons of whole wheat pastry flour, 1 cup plus 2 tablespoons of quick cooking oats, 2/3 cup sugar, and this is just regular granulated sugar. We are also going to be using 1 teaspoon of baking soda and 3 tablespoons of the light corn syrup. And we're going to be using 2 tablespoons of prune butter. I'll explain. I'm taking 8 ounces of these prunes and I'm going to put them in a food processor with 6 tablespoons of water, pulse it, and just until it's creamy. And then I'm going to only be using 2 tablespoons of that prune butter in this recipe. I'm also using 1/4 cup plus 2 tablespoons of orange juice, and 1/2 cup of dried cranberries, and 1/4 cup of pecans, toasted if you'd like. That would be really nice, but it doesn't have to be. All right, let's get started. So here I am making my prune butter. I'm gonna set that aside once that's done. Basically, in one bowl, you're gonna add all the dry ingredients. So into the bowl goes the whole wheat pastry flour, the quick cooking oats, the sugar, baking soda, and I'm just going to whisk them up. And then in a separate bowl, all the wet ingredients, the 2 tablespoons of the prune butter, the orange juice, and I'm just going to kind of, and the light corn syrup, and just kind of whisk that up. And now I'm going to be putting the wet ingredients into the dry ingredients, super duper easy. And I'm going to fold that in. Very nice. Okay, so one thing I wanted to tell you about, oh, let's put in the cranberries and the pecans. I used an ice cream scooper to kind of like, you know, dole them out onto the cookie sheet. Now I'm going to have to flatten them because they don't really spread out that much. So I kind of want them looking more like cookies instead of little haystacks. So I'm just gonna kind of like push them down a little bit and help them take that cookie shape. I was really, really surprised at how moist they stayed inside. I actually stored them in a Ziploc bag on top of the counter. Now I'm going to be cooking them at 275 for about 20 minutes. And I'm gonna cool them in the pan for 1 minute. And they are just so good. I love them, my husband loved them, the kids loved them. I will definitely be making these again and I highly recommend them. They're 2 points each and full of fiber. Guys, that's it for me for tonight. I hope you're having a wonderful holiday season. And I want to thank Miranda and Brittany again for inviting me to this collab. All right, guys, I will see you next time. Love you guys. Bye.